Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do a color texture scan in the blue laser mode with the Creality Scan laptop and the Sermoon series. So I'm going to demonstrate 3D scan this Mickey Mouse. I will make three scans, one in the standing position, and facing up, and then facing down, and then I will merge them together. Okay, first you need to update the Creality Scan 4 to the latest version 1.4.7 because the version before this, you'll be able to scan blue laser mode with the color texture. After updating the software, when you plug in your 3D scanner, it will prompt you to update the firmware. And then you come to this page, the scan page, and you need to click on here, global marker. There will be a new tab. Color mapping. This tab is inside the global marker, so you need to click on the global marker to be able to do the color scanning. You click on here, turn it on. With this new software update, the scanner will scan the color with the RGB camera together with the markers. The scanner will register the position of the color with the marker, and then you can continue to scan for the point cloud, and then it will fuse the color back into the point cloud. Okay, next you can click on the start. You see that it will emit the white LED, and you have to look at the preview screen here. The white color is burned out. You need to adjust it manually. You need to like this. And when you scan for the color and the marker, you need to look at the RGB camera preview screen on the right. So you need to scan the color together with the marker. So you won't see the color on the preview screen, but you can see it from the RGB camera preview on the right corner. Okay, now you can continue to scan with the point cloud. Click on OK. Now I'm going to use 0.15mm for the resolution and scan with the parallel line. You can continue to scan this. Okay, now you scan with the white cloud. If you look at the bottom of the screen, there's a tab. It says color next to the resolution. It means that this scan will have a color information. This process is the same for the laptops. I have already tried. Okay, and it's done. And next I'm going to clipping the plane. Same as usual. Click on finish. Okay, I'm going to move to the next scan. I have to do the same. So I will click on the global marker and scan the color with the marker. The white LED tends to overexpose. So you need to do the manual adjustment. This is like a photogrammetry. And one update that they make in this version is that they have increased the frame limit from 40,000 to 60,000 frames. So you can scan with a single line for a longer time. Okay, so it's done. Okay, the final scan. So mainly you need to look at the RGB preview windows, the color camera windows for scanning the color. So the Sermoon S1 has been released for 3 months. The software version before this, you can't scan the color in the blue laser mode, but now you can't. And they have already increased the frame limit. So I'm going to click on the 3 scan, holding the control key, and click on the fusion. I'm going to fuse it in a batch, 0.15mm. Okay, after fusing the point cloud, the turntable, some part of the turntable will come back if you scan with the color. So you need to delete it manually. So the plane clipping is not working with the color scanned, something that you should know. So you need to delete it manually. Click on save. Save. Okay, the last one. The mesh look good. Okay, now you won't see any color yet. You need to align them first. The 3 scan. you need to merge them together. Click on alignment, click on align. It's automatic alignment should work. Overall, it looks okay. Okay, next I'm going to mesh this scan together. Now you can slide it to 20 million. That's the maximum polygon that you can output with the Creality Scan 4, 1.4.7. So I'm going to choose 2 million. Click on apply. Okay, now you have a mesh that we usually use in reverse engineering. But this time, if you look here, the color mapping button, now you can click on it. If you scan without the color, this button will not be enabled. So now it's enabled. Just click on here. This is the color texture map onto the mesh. It may not look good in this preview window. You need to export it and view it with the 3D software. You see texture files here in PNG format. Creality Raptors or the Sermoon series is not meant for scanning color. They're made for metrology scanning. The camera that comes with the scanner is not a high resolution camera. But in this demonstration, I will just show you that it's capable of scanning the color in the blue laser mode. So the image size is 4000 by 4000 pixels. So it's 16 megapixels. I don't think you can make it higher than this. They limit the texture size to 16 megapixels. So if you scan larger object like a car, you are going to have the same size of the texture. Okay, here's a color result in the render scene, ray tracing. There's no color shifting, but I can notice the refraction. When you scan this, it has a glossy surface. Actually, this one has to be in a gray color, but it reflects the yellow color here onto its surface. So you see the yellow color here. Look like a stained color stain, but it's a reflection when you scan it. And I didn't use spray, of course. The black color looks okay. White is okay. If I didn't adjust the brightness manually, it's going to burn out. The only issue that I can find here is the reflection. It will reflect the color from the surrounding onto the surface. Okay, let's move to the back. Okay, not bad, I think. Not the best. Yeah, the best one that I scanned this, I was using the Mark 3. And the color resolution is higher, much higher than this. Let's look at the bottom. If I use Mark 3 to scan this, I can read the text here. It's give an okay result, but not the best. So here's your color mapping with the blue laser scan. It's doable, but I know what you are going to use it for. Thanks you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.